I think innovation is very hard to define because most people take the simplistic approach to thinking of it as the invention of something. Like the wheel is a great invention, or, you know, the computer. It's rarely that invention in and of itself that is an innovation. To me, the difference between the two is invention tends to be the thing. Innovation is the acceptance of some invention in such a meaningful way that it literally changes the way a broad group of people experience life.
I think the history of the world is the history of innovation, driven by people with passion. And I think his work in developing countries and the purification of water reflects that. His work in medical areas and insulin delivery and dialysis. And I think he'd like to see the world be a happier place.
I think innovation evolves. You have an idea about some really big problem. The world doesn't have enough clean water. How do you move all the pieces to make water more available? Almost every project we've ever worked on morphed over time. The technology that's available gets better. We systems integrate those technologies and make some solution to a problem until finally there's a sea change in the way we treat some cancer, or we cure some disease, or we create some method of doing something that just wasn't available before. The iBOT was for people that, for one reason or other, can't walk. And we realized that a wheelchair is never going to restore to people that can't walk the kind of lifestyle you and I expect. We said, to do curbs and stairs and look people in the eye, you've got to make a machine like a human body. It has to balance and stand on a small footprint. Could we restore to people that capability? Yes. We realized, unlike most of our other products, take the seat off it, take the cluster that climbs stairs off it, and what you have left, almost as a fun sideshow, would be a product that the rest of the population might find fun and useful. The Segway. So the Segway really is nothing we ever set out to develop. It was the result of spending so many years understanding human balance. They're being used by all sorts of specialty markets, police, security. We're seeing more and more college campuses with Segways on them. I think in part it's because it's a nice environment. It's about the right distances to make them productive and fun, and kids like them. And again, every new generation stands on the shoulders of the generation before it and just accepts technologies as being appropriate. The best stimulus package this country could possibly invest in is creating a generation of kids capable of solving really big problems. I think FIRST is one of the best solutions to a lot of that.
The more you learn, the more power you have to solve real problems.
Coming to know Dean and that program FIRST, you get high school students, and then they're supposed to build robots, and they compete with one another. And you arrange for professional engineers who are in industry to come in and coach the kids. And it was phenomenal. The field house from ceiling to floor was just throbbing. And it was like a ball game. And then when the competition came on, they had their cheerleaders, and the cheerleaders came out and cheered these kids on. And they did remarkable things.
Most of them, statistically, without FIRST, wouldn't go into science and technology at all. Many of them because of FIRST will.
1 million American students have been through that program. Now just think of this, 1 million American students, okay? Let's say the 1% of them go into science and engineering who wouldn't have. That's 10,000. 1% of them become half as good as Dean Kamen. That's 100. That's 50 full-time equivalent Dean Kamens. Imagine what this world would be with 50 Dean Kamens running around.
I am confident that in my lifetime, we're going to hear of some, in fact, many great advances in the world of science and technology. And when they go investigate who and how it all evolved, at the base of it, some kid is going to, or by then, some professional is going to say, I kind of got started on all this because when I was a kid, I got involved with FIRST, and I never looked back.
RIT, Dean Kamen, and innovation, I think we're all in the same boat, and we're sailing with the wind.
You create a generation of innovators that can solve the world's problems. A, you solve the world problems. B, you will have created wealth in the process for those kids and the people and companies and industries that grow from their ideas. I think you have to work on trading time only for accomplishments that are meaningful. Medical products are meaningful. FIRST, creating changes in kids' attitudes are meaningful. Water for the developing world is meaningful. Electricity for the developing world is meaningful. So you look at all of our project and you can say Stirling engines and vapor compression distillers and medical products and FIRST are all different. I think they're all the same. We're looking at finding ways to leverage technology to make the world a better place.